Do you waste time recording the same exact transactions each month? Well, then you can use the QuickBooks Online feature, Recurring Transactions. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Recurring transactions are transactions that happen at the same time every month and will be the same amount for every month and can be set up to have QuickBooks Online record them automatically. This is very similar to the Memorizing Transactions feature in the desktop version of QuickBooks. So what transactions can be automatically entered? Well, monthly subscriptions that are billed at the same amount and same time each month. What about rent that's due for the same amount at the same time each month? And anything like a car payment or any other kind of installment loan that's due at the same time each month and will always be the same amount. So what exactly needs to be set up? Well, you must first set up and confirm with your financial institution, and that means bank account or credit card, that the money should be physically paid from that account each month and confirm that it is the same date and the same amount each month. You do this by logging in to your bank account or credit card account and following the directions of your financial institution if they make that feature available. Then you set up QuickBooks Online to record that transaction automatically. So what to do in QuickBooks Online to set this up? Well, you will open the window of the transaction that you want to memorize, and you will record all fields of data in the transaction as if you were going to record it. However, you should not click Save. Instead, click Make Recurring. The recurring window will appear. Then you put in all the information about what dates and how often this transaction will automatically be entered. After saving it, it will then appear on the recurring transaction list. For example, let's imagine that we want to put Dr. Kirk on retainer for $200 per month, paid from the Chase bank account. We will imagine that it is currently December 9th of 2020, and we have already logged in to Chase Bank to set up the auto pay of $200 to Dr. Kirk so he physically gets the money starting January 3rd, 2021, and then every third of the month after that for the whole 2021 year. Well, we start by opening the window and putting in the data as if we are recording the transaction. New, expense. Now, we're paying from Chase Bank account and we're paying to Dr. Kirk. Click No to ask if we should overwrite with the last expense. It's an annoying feature. It doesn't help us. Okay, now, the next date that we want the payment to happen is January 3rd. So that will be the date of the very first one that will be paid automatically. Now, we want the expense category to be vet bills, and the amount will be $200 a month. So the third of every month, we are going to pay this vet bill expense from Chase Bank to Dr. Kirk in the amount of $200, and we assume this is already set up with our bank account. but we do not click Save. We instead click Make Reoccurring. Now, when you do that, the reoccurring expense window will open up with all the information that you put in the transaction window. All you now have to put is the interval, and most of the time the interval is monthly for a recurring transaction, and that's why monthly is the default, but it doesn't have to be. I did an experiment that I did daily that I'm going to show you later. But in this example, we click monthly, and we want it to be on the third day of every month. And we don't want it to skip a month. We could have it record every second month or every third month, but normally it would be every month, so you would leave the number one in this field. And the start date will be, of course, January 3rd, the day we want the automatic transaction to record the first automatic expense. Now, technically, this is a template, so we click Save Template. And we know that it's safe because we can click the cog wheel and come over to the List column and choose Reoccurring Transactions. And you can see that the next date would be January 3rd. It's an expense, it's scheduled to Dr. Kirk, and if we need to see any more details or even change the details of the interval of which it pays, we can click Edit, and we can change anything we need and then click Save. And as you can see, you could have several reoccurring transactions because this is a full list and you would manage them here in the Recurring Transactions window. So what will you see as evidence of this memorized reoccurring transaction? Well, when you log in on the morning of January 3rd, 2021, you will see the results of the transaction that was automatically recorded. You can open the accounts to see the transaction was entered with the proper information. Let's see what it would look like when logging in on January 3rd. We can click Reports. Believe me, we clicked Reports. And then we can click Custom Reports, Trial Balance. Now we know Vet Bills should have recorded a January 3rd expense for $200. Double click. And there it is, January 3rd, 2021, Vet Bills in the amount of $200 for Dr. Kirk. You can also click Reports, Trial Balance, Chase Bank, and you'll see January 3rd expense to Dr. Kirk for vet bills, $200. Now the lesson is finished, and you don't have to watch the rest of this video. However, in a different QuickBooks Online account, I set up a recurring transaction. I input this right before midnight on December 7th, 2020. I set it up as daily so it would be entered by QuickBooks Online as soon as it became December 8th. Let's take a look at the video and see what happened. So this is the reoccurring transaction that I saved, and it's 2 minutes before midnight on December 7th. And if we quickly take a look at the trial balance reports, trial balance, these are the numbers for all dates right before midnight on December 7th. These are the numbers, so you can rewind the video to this point. But if we click the cog wheel and we click reoccurring transactions, you can see, oh, it's 11:59. You can see the one that I made. I made the next date is December 8th and it's 5,000. And if I open it up by clicking edit, you can see that it started today, but I didn't record one today on December 7th. And you can see that it's a daily, once a day for $5,000, it will increase telephone expense. And for $5,000, it'll increase Citibank credit card. And neither of those balances were even close to 5,000, but right after midnight, you see here, right after it hits midnight, because it begins today, but I didn't record it. And the next one is on 12/8. it said the next, in that other window, it said the next one's on 12/8. So it's almost 12/8. So as soon as it's 12/8, it will be a $5,000 increase in telephone expense and $5,000 increase in the city credit card. And this will have been recorded for the first time. So watch it, hear it. Now it just turned. So it is now Tuesday, December 8th at 2020. Now let's see how soon it updates it. Account as reports, trial balance, nothing yet. Okay, so this says cash Tuesday, December 8th, 2020 at 12:02 a.m. GMT5. I don't know what that means. So it didn't update it yet, but QuickBooks is in California, so we'll be checking in every 15 minutes or half hour to see when what time the memorized transaction is recorded. I actually instead fell asleep and woke up at 10:30 a.m. the next morning on December 8th. Now here we are the next morning on December 8th at 10:25 a.m. And if we click reports and then we click trial balance, you can see that the $5,000 was added to the balance of the credit card and the $5,000 was added to the balance of telephone expense. Now you may well ask, what time in the morning? Because we checked to see if it happened right after midnight on Eastern Standard Time, and it did not. But it definitely happened before 10:27 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. So of course, to find out the exact time that anything happened, we would open the audit trail. Click the cog wheel, and then we go over to audit log. Now you may well ask, what is the audit log? Well, it is a list of every activity that has ever been done in the account from the very beginning. For each activity, it includes the date, the time, who did it, the activity itself, what activity it was, and if it was a transaction, it will show transaction details. It cannot be erased or changed by anyone, ha ha. And then we go over to audit log. Now, we can see, I logged in this morning, but we can see at 4:12 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, which is just a few minutes after midnight in California, they added an expense on December 8th for $5,000. So this is the date and time that the $5,000 was recorded as per what we set up with automatic transactions.